to everything. Turn, turn, turn. There is a season. Turn, turn, turn. And a time to every purpose under heaven. A time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, a time to reap, a time to kill, a time to heal, a time to laugh, a time to weep. To everything, turn, turn, turn. There is a season, turn. And a time to every purpose under heaven. A time to build up, a time to break down, a time to dance, a time to mourn, a time to cast away stones, a time to gather stones together. To everything. Is a season, turn, 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 and a time to every purpose under heaven. A time of war, a time of peace, a time of love, a time of hate, a time you may embrace, a time to refrain from. To everything, turn, turn, turn. There is a season, turn, turn, turn. And a time to every purpose under heaven. A time to gain, a time to lose, a time to rent, a time to sow. A time of love, a time of hate, a time of peace. I swear it's not too late. To everything, turn, turn, turn. There is a season, turn, turn, turn. And a time to every purpose under heaven.
Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And blessed be God's kingdom, now and forever. Amen. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Glory, glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father. Glory to God in the highest. Glory, glory to God in the highest. And on earth he is to people of good will. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Everlasting God, you have ordained and constituted in a wonderful order the ministries of angels and mortals. Mercifully grant that as your holy angels always serve and worship you in heaven, so by your appointment they may help and defend us here on earth through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord our God, King of the universe. You love your people and have given us the words of eternal life. O Lord, God of our salvation, your word is the light of our lives and the lantern of our feet. Teach us and lead us with the light of your eternal word.
A reading from Genesis 28, verses 10 to 17. Jacob left Beersheba and went toward Haran. He came to a certain place and stayed there for the night because the sun had set. Taking one of the stones of the place, he put it under his head and lay down in that place. And he dreamed that there was a ladder set up on the earth, the top of it reaching to heaven. The angels of God were ascending and descending on it. And the Lord stood beside him and said, I am the Lord, the God of Abraham, your father, and the God of Isaac. The land on which you lie I will give to you and to your offspring. And your offspring shall be like the dust of the earth, and you shall spread abroad to the west and to the east and to the north and to the south. And all the families of the earth shall be blessed in you and in your offsprings. Know that I am with you and will keep you wherever you go and will bring you back to this land. For I will not leave you until I have done that I have promised you. Then Jacob woke from his sleep and said, surely the Lord is in this place, and I did not know it. And he was afraid and said, how awesome in this place. This is none other than the house of God, and this is the gate of heaven. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. A reading from the book of Revelation, chapter 12, verses 7 to 12. War broke out in heaven. Michael and his angels fought against the dragon. The dragon and his angels fought back, but they were defeated, and there was no longer any place for them in heaven. The great dragon was thrown down, that ancient serpent, who is called the devil and Satan, the deceiver of the world. He was thrown down to the earth, and his angels were thrown down with him. Then I heard a loud voice in heaven proclaiming, "Now have come the salvation and the power and the kingdom of our God and the authority of his Messiah. For the accuser of our comrades has been thrown down, who accuses them day and night before our God. But they have conquered him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. For they did not cling to life even in the face of death. Rejoice then, you heavens and those who dwell in them. But woe to the earth and the sea, for the devil has come down to you with great wrath, because he knows that his time is short." The word of the Lord.
I was walking down from school on a cold and winter day. Took a shortcut through the woods, and I lost my way. It was getting late, and I was scared and alone. But then a kind old man took my hand and led me home. Mama couldn't see him, oh, but he was standing there. I knew in my heart he was the answer to my prayer. Oh, I believe there are angels among us, sent down to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me in our darkest hours, to show us how to live and teach us how to give, to guide us with the light of love. When life held trouble, several times and have me down on my knees. There's always been someone to come along and comfort me. A kind word from a stranger to lend a helping hand. A phone call from a friend just to say, I understand. Ain't kind of funny at the dark end of the road, someone lights the way with just a single ray of hope. Oh, I believe there are angels among us, sent down to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me in our darkest hours to show us how to live and teach us how to give and guide us with a light of love. They wear so many faces, show up in the strangest places and graze us with the mercies in our time of need. Oh, I believe there are angels among us, sent down to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me in our darkest hours to show us how to live and teach us how to give, to guide us with a light of love, and guide us with a light of love.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
When Jesus saw Nathanael coming toward him, he said of him, "Here is truly an Israelite in whom there is no deceit." Nathanael asked him, "Where did you get to know me?" Jesus answered, "I saw you under the fig tree before Philip called you." Nathanael replied, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus answered, "Do you believe because I told you that I saw you under the fig tree? You will see greater things than these." And he said to him, "Very truly, I tell you, you will see heaven opened and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man." The Gospel of the Lord.
And now, in the name of our loving, liberating, and life-giving God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, amen. On behalf of your brothers, sisters, and siblings who are the Episcopal Church, wherever they may be, I bring you their greetings, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Today we are observing the Feast of St. Michael and All Angels. I would ask you to consider two passages of scripture. One from the book of Revelation, the story of Michael casting the devil out of heaven from Revelation 12. The other from John 13, the words of Jesus spoken at the Last Supper. Start with the words of Jesus. "A new commandment I give you, that you love one another as I have loved you. For by this the world will know that you are my disciples, that you have love for one another. And from Revelation 12, war broke out in heaven. Michael and his angels fought against the dragon. The dragon and his angels fought back, but they were defeated, and there was no longer any place for them in heaven. The great dragon was thrown down, that ancient serpent who is called the devil and Satan, the deceiver of the whole world. He was thrown down to the earth, and his angels thrown down with him. A new commandment I give you, that you love one another as I have loved you. I want to talk about the courage to love. Courage to love. But let me back into it. Your bishop, Bishop Mark, and I have been friends for many years, going back to his time serving in Alabama and when I was in North Carolina. And it was during that time when I was about to go on a sabbatical leave after having served 7 or 8 years in North Carolina, the diocese granted me a leave. And so I was getting ready to do that, and your bishop and I had been talking for a while about avocational things that I could do that would actually get my mind off of work, that would be not only relaxing, but might be beneficial and blessing. And so he talked me into taking up the violin, and I did. And it turned out to be a real blessing for me, maybe not for anyone who heard it, but for me. And so I started taking violin lessons on sabbatical and continued taking my lessons with a wonderful teacher who had taught at Meredith College, a liberal arts school for girls here in Raleigh, North Carolina. She had taught for 50 years and was then retired when she was working with me. One of the things I learned about the violin, and it's true of string instruments, is that without tension on the string, without tension, there is no music. Now, you can't have too much tension, but you can't have too little. Just the right amount of tension between the ends of the string make it possible, when the bow is proper, there's enough tension for there to be music. There is tension between these two texts. A new commandment I give you, that you love one another. And there was war in heaven. Michael and the angels against the dragon and his angels. Love, war, nonviolence, violence. There's a tension in these two passages held in the same Holy Scripture. And yet I want to suggest that the tension is not a flat out contradiction. That would be too much tension. The tension is one that one of my professors in seminary, the late Brevard Child, was the leader of a movement called canonical criticism, in which he said it's important when interpreting sacred texts to remember that the rabbis included all those texts in what is now the canon of the Hebrew Bible, and that the church included all of these texts in what is the canon of the New Testament, that there is a built-in tension that undoubtedly the framers of our scriptures, guided by the Spirit, they knew the tension was there, and they left both texts in Holy Scripture. When I look at that tension and look more deeply, I think I can see it. Jesus, a new commandment I give you, that you love one another. He says it in John's gospel at the Last Supper. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, that you have love for one another. At the Last Supper in John chapters 13 through 17, as the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Abide in my love. As in John at the Last Supper, chapters 13 through 17, a remarkable set of passages where Jesus is giving his disciples what they need to know when he's not with them physically anymore. He says to them, greater love has no one than this, but that they give up their life for their friends. And I have called you friends. Love, Love as Judas slithers out of the room. Love. Love as Peter would soon deny him in spite of his protestations. Love. When he's arrested in a garden. Love. When he's pulled off his knees by soldiers. Love. When he's tried unjustly and convicted of crimes he never committed. Love. When he's tortured. Love. When he carries a cross. Love. And those hands that only healed are nailed to wood. Love. His mama watches him die. Love, woman, behold your son, behold your mother. Love, when it is finished and he gives up the ghost. Love, when they put him in his mama's arms. Love, when a rich man, Joseph of Arimathea, buries him in his tomb. And love, when the earth would quake days later. Love, when God would raise him from the dead. Love, when he would appear to his followers, peace be with you. Love. But then in Revelation, there was war in heaven. Michael and the angels fighting against the dragon and his angels, and then they kick the dragon and his angels out of heaven and kick him down to earth. What's going on there? Raymond Brown, the late Raymond Brown, Roman Catholic, a biblical scholar, a Johannine scholar, in one of his books talks about the Johannine communities, the communities that trace their, Christian communities that trace their origin to the teachings of John, possibly the author of the gospel, we don't know, but certainly the gospel itself, and then three epistles, first, second, and third John, and possibly even the book of Revelation, while they may or may not be the same individual John, they probably arose out of a common community that traced its origins to the understandings of Jesus that John held. And that in that those collections of works, if you look at the Gospels, love is the cornerstone of Jesus's teachings in John's gospel, and it gets picked up again in the epistles in 1 John chapter 4. Beloved, let us love one another because love is of God, and those who love are born of God and know God. Why? Because God is love. And yet the book of Revelation is seen as having come out of those same communities. What is the relationship between a gospel of love and a book with war? In heaven, if you look back, the book of Revelation may well clearly dates from a period of persecution, whether it was the period under the Emperor Domitian or the period of the Emperor Nero, we're not sure, but it was a period of persecution. And those who stood for love, those who dared to follow Jesus in his way of unselfish, sacrificial love that works and seeks the good and the welfare and the well-being of others. When a community that was built around this love, Raymond Brown says, this community was fashioned around love, and these were churches where men and women were equals. These were churches where slave and free were equals. These were churches that actually lived out the egalitarian teachings of the kingdom of God, of the beloved community. That's what these Johannine communities were, and they were being persecuted by the Empire of Rome. And the book of Revelation was composed to tell them, hold on, hold on. You are in a struggle. You are in a struggle for good. Hold on, not with the weapons of hate, not with the weapons of violence, but with the weapon of love, with the ways of love that can change and transform our jangling discords and our disconnects with one another into, as Dr. King said, a glorious symphony of beauty, of hope, of beloved community. Hold on with the discipline of a soldier. Hold on with the courage of a soldier. Hold on in the cause of truth. Because in the end, love's gonna win. If you read further in the passage from Revelation, after the devil is kicked out of heaven, the text then says, "Then I heard a loud voice from heaven saying, 'Rejoice, you heavens, and those who dwell in them. But woe to the earth and to the sea, for the devil has come down to you with great wrath.'" Check this out. "Because he knows his time is short. Hatred will not last forever. Violence will not last forever. Injustice will not last forever. Wrong will not last forever." James Russell Lowell, who was part of the abolitionist movement in the 19th century, James Russell Lowell, who lived through the Civil War, James Russell Lowell, who saw the indignities and injustice of the Spanish-American War, was someone who fought and labored for the causes that were right. And even in days when he wasn't sure if right would be might, if right could win the day, he wrote these words, and I quote, "Truth may forever be on the scaffold. Wrong may forever be on the throne. But that scaffold that sways the future, and behind the dim unknown standeth God within the shadow, keeping watch above his own. Courage to love." That's what Revelation was trying to teach. The courage to love. That's what we see in Jesus. The courage to love. That's what we are called to as his followers. Charles Marsh, in his book on the civil rights movement and its spirituality and theology, at one point says this, and I quote, "Jesus began the most revolutionary movement in all of human history. It was a movement of people who were committed to Jesus and his way of love, and that way of love transformed their lives, and it transformed the world around them." And my friends, what Jesus and his way of love did in the first century can continue to do now in the 21st century, in spite of odds, in spite of opposition, in spite of injustice, in spite of wrong, in spite of what we often see in front of us, in spite of it all. Love's gonna win. We must summon the courage to love. One of my favorite books that I periodically pick up and reread was Paul Tillich's The Courage to Be, written those lectures that he gave years ago, I think in the early 1960s. And in that book, he talks about faith and the courage to be. And he says, faith and the courage to be. Faith is not the absence of doubts or uncertainties. It's not even sometimes clenching your fist and raising it to heaven. It's not even the absence of frustration with the way things are. He said, no. Faith is the courage to be in spite of what you can see. Faith is the courage to hope in spite of hopeless situations. Faith is the courage to be in spite of the odds being against you, in spite of all of the evidence that you can see. Faith is the courage to hold on to love in spite of hatred. Hold on to compassion in spite of the desire to grieve. Have the courage to love. It's the courage of life. Mahatma Gandhi said it this way: "I regard myself as a soldier of peace. For I know the value of discipline, the value of love, of truth, and the power of love." I'm doing this sermon on Wednesday at the very hour that the late Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg, her body had been carried by some of her law clerks into the rotunda of the Supreme Court, where the words equal justice under law are inscribed above the temple. There was someone who dared to live a life not for self alone, but for others. That's love. There is a life of one who was willing to stand up when others would sit down. That's love. There was one who did not take up the sword, but took up the pen, took up the argument, took up the cause, even before it was popular or safe to do so, dared to be a woman and take her place in the councils of law. There was a woman who showed the way. And but a few weeks before, I saw another casket, like Ruth Bader Ginsburg's, draped in an American flag. That one was carried in a caisson, with horses carrying it. That one crossed the Edmund Pettus Bridge. That one carried the body of the late Congressman John Lewis. There was another one who stood not for self alone, but for others, who believed and said that love is the way to save us all. For love is the mother of justice. Love is the mother of compassion. Love is the mother of equality. There was John Lewis. There is Ruth Bader Ginsburg. And now, there must be some rejoicing up in heaven, because the saints have gathered in. Those who stood the test of time. Those who did not hate, but stood for what was loving, what was just, what was humane, what was decent, what was kind, what was meant for us all. We too, like them, like saints who have gone before, like the Jesus whom we followed, must take up the cross of hardship and sometimes suffering and follow in the footsteps in the way of love. And fear not. Fear not. Because in the end, love's gonna win. Though the cause of evil prosper, yet 'tis truth alone is strong. Though her portion be a scaffold, and upon the throne be wrong, yet that scaffold it sways the future. And behind the dim unknown standeth God, keeping watch above his own. Walk together, children, and don't you get weary. Because Ruth Bader Ginsburg, John Lewis, C.T. Vivian, and a host of others, don't you get weary. Because there's a great camp meeting in the promised land. Amen.
I would like to thank Grace Cathedral and the Diocese of California for sharing the video sermon of the Presiding Bishop Michael Curry. The Presiding Bishop is the head of the Episcopal Church in the United States and in other provinces. And we're thankful for being able to share that video message. Today at 12:30, he will be at Grace Cathedral for a forum. You can visit gracecathedral.org. Let us all rise, and in the words of the Nicene Creed, let us profess our faith. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again. In accordance with the scriptures, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge this forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The prayers of the people. With all our hearts and with all our mind, let us pray to the Lord, saying, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above, for the loving kindness of God, and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the world, for the welfare of the Holy Church of God, and for the unity of all peoples, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our bishop and for all the clergy and people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our president, for the leaders of nations, and for all in authority, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city, for every city and community, and for those who live in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For seasonable weather and for an abundance of the fruits of the earth, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the good earth which God has given us, and for the wisdom and will to conserve it, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the aged and infirm, for the widowed and orphans, for the sick and the suffering, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the poor and all oppressed, for the unemployed and the destitute, for prisoners and captives, and for all who remember and care for them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who have died in the hope of the resurrection, and for all the departed, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For deliverance from all danger, violence, oppression, and degradation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the absolution and remission of our sins and offenses, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That we may end our lives in faith and hope, without suffering and without reproach, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
In the communion of all the saints, of all the angels, Let us commend ourselves and one another and all our life to Christ our God. To thee, O Lord, our God.
Let us also include in our prayers those who are celebrating their birthdays this week. For Marcelino Guillermo Jr., Abigail Pailano, and all others whom you may now name silently or aloud. Or Deacon Nan Slavin. May God bless you more and more as you live out your life and share the love of God among all. Amen. For those who are celebrating their wedding anniversaries, whom you may now name silently or aloud. Eric.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles,
pray for the well recovery of Marietta Flores, Lisa Soberano, Grace Carlin, Mayette Garcia, Lily Alves, Daniela Ramos, Jim Pettit, Vic and Astrid Aguliana, Isabel Marcela Romil Lulukisan, Marcelino Guillermo Jr., Pasita Dasquiu, and others whom you may now name silently or aloud. May God's healing hand be with you and strengthen you. We remember our loved ones who are now with God, especially Peter Longid, Jane Longid, Poresa Longid Fernandez, the Reverend Vitaliano Duterte Delfin, Duarte Delfin, rather, Andrew Haas, Rufina Estrera, Antonio Robles Jr., Eugenio R. Sungduan, and others whom you may now name silently or aloud. We also pray for the father of Father Roland de la Rosa, who passed away, Salvador de la Rosa.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I give to you, my own peace I leave with you. Regard not our sins, but the faith of your church, and give to us the peace and unity of that heavenly city, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, now and forever. Amen.
Amen. Beloved in the Lord, we are the body of Christ. In one spirit, we were all baptized into one body. Let us strive to keep the unity of the Spirit in a bond of peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Virtual hugs to all. Peace be with you, friends all over the world, wherever you may be. God bless us all. Share the love. Let love be all around us. Now let us listen to a song for peace by Angela Canlas.
Every day I feel the joy of living, even when it seems the sun's not shining. I know someone's watching me,
For your continued support to the church and to her mission, either on whatever means that you are able to give, your time, your talent, your resources. Thank you, and may God bless us all. Also, I'd like to thank the following who made this virtual service possible. Via Zoom and Facebook, who have not had, who had a nonstop sitting down to make this possible, especially to Hannah Baluyot and Jerry Buena Vista. Thank you so much for putting your time. To Joshua Oaks, Jasmine Call, Rebecca Goldberg, thank you so much, Reverend Rebecca Goldberg, Reverend Father Yurk Fernandez, to Haley Oaks for reading, and Heidi Oaks, and to Mama Hilaria for the flowers, and to others who are here. Thank you so much. It's all for the glory of God. In all things that I have shown you, that by so toiling, one must help the weak, remembering the words of the Lord Jesus, how he said, it is more blessed to give than to receive. I forgot to include Omar Zaleta, Rhea Cancel, and her daughter Angela Canlas, and Excel Roy Zaleta. Thank you so much. And also to Conrad Marzan for sharing your songs. And John Yani Tayag, thank you so much. Let us with gladness present the offering of our life and work to the Lord. Let's again listen to the song for the offertory from John Tyab. Let us all rise and sing the doxology. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him all creatures here below. Praise Him above ye heavenly hosts. Praise God the Father and Holy Ghost. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. O God of creation, you are always with us. You breathe among us. You unite us in your love, and so we praise you and we bless you. We praise you, we bless you, we give you thanks, and we pray to you, God Most High. Your Son Jesus finds each separate heart. He gathers us together. He welcomes us all into communion, and so we praise and bless you. We praise you, we bless you, we give thanks to you, and we pray to you, God Most High. Your beloved community has met in prayer to reveal Christ in this bread and in this wine. And now we meet once more to praise and bless you. We praise you, we bless you, we give thanks to you, and we pray to you, God Most High. Show us, gathered here, that we too are Christ's body, joined to all your human family throughout the ages. In your love, feed us. Inspire us. Fill us with Christ's life that we may fill our lives with you. Make this sharing radiant with your presence and send us out into the world to shine forth your truth to all, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The gifts of God for the people of God. Holy food for holy people.
One is Lord.
And for those who are not able to receive communion today, let us pray with them for the prayer for spiritual communion. In union, dear Lord, with the faithful at every altar of your church, where your blessed body and blood are being offered to the Father, I desire to offer you praise and thanksgiving. I believe that you are truly present in the Holy Sacrament, and since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, I entreat you to come spiritually in my heart. I unite myself to you and embrace you with all affections of my soul. Let me never be separated from you. Let me live and die in your love. Amen. Now, as we receive the communion, Let us listen to a song, "Surely the Goodness of the Lord is in this Place."
Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. I can feel His mighty power and His grace. I can hear the rush of angels' wings. I see glory on each face. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. In the midst of His children, the Lord said He would be. It doesn't take very many. It can be just two or three. And I feel that same sweet spirit that I've felt all times before. Surely I can say I've been with the Lord. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. I can feel His mighty power and His grace. I can hear the rush of angels' wings. I see glory on each face. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place.
Let us all say together the post-communion prayer. O gracious God, whose Christ has stretched out arms of love upon the hardwood of the cross to embrace all the peoples of the earth, we give you thanks for feeding us with the sacrament of that precious body and blood, which is a sign and instrument of our common life, the food of our pilgrimage, the foretaste of that heavenly banquet of which we shall partake with all your saints, through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. And may the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God the Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Rebecca, go there. Dismiss us.
Go forth into the world rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit.
Thanks be to God. I invite you again next Sunday for our virtual service. It will be done here at church. And again, thank you all for joining us. And for our recessional song, "Lead Me, Lord," by John Tayag. Thank you.
Lead me, Lord. Lead me by the hand and make me face the rising sun. Comfort me through all the pain that life may bring. There's no other hope that I can lean upon. Lead me, Lord. Lead me all my life. Walk by me. Walk by me across the lonely road of every day. Take my arms and let your hand show me the way. Show the way to live inside your heart. Lead me, Lord. Lead me all my life. You are my light. You're the lamp upon my feet. All the time, my Lord, I need you there. You are my life. I cannot live alone. Let me stay by your guiding love all through my life. Lead me, Lord. Lead me, Lord. Even though at times I'd rather go along my way, help me take the right directions, take your road. Lead me, Lord, and never leave my side. All my days, all my life. You are my light. You're the lamp upon my feet. All the time, my Lord, I need you there. You are my life. I cannot live alone. Let me stay by your guiding love all through my life. You are my life.
Thank you again. God bless us all. See you next Sunday. Bye.